Okay, hello. You were listening to Those Are the Girls with Mallory and Friends. I'm Mallory, and we are changing culture and bringing back traditional values. I am super happy that you're listening. This is a Saturday teacap, technically, but it is a solo episode. And, I wrote out this entire docket, but because of my schedule and schedules of other guests that I typically have on or I want to have on, couldn't fit it all. We couldn't figure it out. And the topics I wanted to discuss are definitely for two people. So, because I was like, if I just give my opinion and we're not really discussing it, it's not as exciting. So I decided, you know what, won't do those topics, throwing that out the window. But I still wanted to give you guys an episode for a Saturday morning, because that is what we're doing here. We are providing episodes every Saturday morning and hopefully every Tuesday morning. Saturdays are for teacaps. So I was like, well, what should I talk about then if I'm not really going to be talking about the topics? So then I was like, okay, what's going on? What's going on in the world today? And it's Valentine's. It's February or Galentine's. That's the only holiday I personally celebrate in February is Galentine's Day. Joking, not joking. So yeah, I was like, well, maybe we can talk about like friendship. I think that friendship is a topic that, especially when you get older, like after college, it is so hard to find friends. And I kind of just wanted to talk about like my journey finding friends and yeah, and Galentine's Day and why I think every girl listening should try to do something for Galentine's Day. This will be out February 11th, which is going to be 2 days before Galentine's Day. And this will be a quick episode, I'm sure. But I think that'll just be, I think it'll be fun episode to do, to be. A fun episode to be, yep. A fun episode to be, a fun episode to do, and for you guys to listen to. But before I want to get into that, I want to do a couple announcements. The first one is I'm super excited. I cannot share. I hate when people do this, but I'm doing it anyway. I cannot share exactly what has happened, but I got some news today for something really great and amazing. That technically, I guess, all the I's will be dotted and the T's crossed by the time you hear this, but I'm not 100% sure, so I don't want to say it just yet. But something really cool and amazing is going to be happening with Those Are the Girls. And actually, I guess technically two amazing things, but like one big, I'll say an event is going to happen. And I'm very excited. And if you are part of the Patreon, which you should join, part of Patreon, you're going to know before everyone else. If you are on our email list, you will know after them. And then if you are just a casual, regular listener, you're going to be notified as well. But you're going to want to either join the Patreon, which is just $5 a month, or you can join for $60 a month, which would truly like five, it starts off at five, I believe it's five, 30, then 60. It will really make a difference. It costs money to run the podcast, to finally get some good mics. And I want to get some good mics for some of the co-hosts that we have and things like that. It costs money. So right now it all comes out of my pocket, except for whenever you guys donate or order merch, then that goes straight to the podcast. I don't pocket anything. It all goes to the podcast because we got to pay the bills. We got to get this. And I always want to offer great content. I am aware of some of the audio issues, and I'm really trying to figure out how to fix that on the other end of for our guests and the co-hosts. So part of that is finances. That's how, I'm not going to name names, but other podcasts are able to get these big guests. They're able to do a lot more because when you have big companies backing you, when you have big companies paying some of the expenses, it's a little bit easier to do certain things, which we don't have. This is a ground up, grassroots, 100% us, as in me, you, the listener, us building this brand, this podcast, this group, this community. It's all us. So if you are listening, you're really enjoying it, I would love if you would consider becoming a Patreon for $5 a month. Right now, I am going to try to do more midweek teacaps to go on the Patreon, where I'm just discussing just random topics. in the middle of the week. There's also other things that we're going to be doing. Like I said, you're going to be the first to be notified about this big thing that's happening. I'm going to make it worth your while. Working on different things to do for the Patreon to, you know, if you're part of it, I want to give you more content and a lot more appreciation for joining. So if you have not already, please consider joining the Patreon. $5 a month. It really, I mean, it's going to make a difference, and your money will be 100% well spent. You do not have to worry about that. It'll be well spent. So the Patreon, I forgot how I got on that topic, but join the Patreon. What was the... I forgot. But also, too, we have merch, really cute merch in the store. Like I said, 100% goes right back into the podcast to help pay for everything that's going on with the podcast. So we really, really appreciate it. Oh, I'm doing announcements. The other announcement, I guess that's it for right now. We're going to be doing raising money again for different causes coming up. Just finalizing some things with that. Next month is Women's Month. So I want to, you guys tell me some topics that you want to, for us to cover, like to get some guests to talk specifically about women related topics. Last year, we had someone talk about birth control. We had Macy from Garnu. We had someone talk about self-defense. I think, I don't remember if it was last year or the year before last, we had someone talk about women who, like, why we're kind of attracted to women, so like witchcraft and like manifestation and things like that. I kind of want her to come on again to discuss that a little bit more. But yeah, you guys tell me, what do you want to hear? What are some guests? What are some topics for Women's Month that you want us to cover? We want to cover a lot of things that have to do with femininity and like recognizing that men and women are different. That's great. That's beautiful. That's wonderful. And that's okay. We are equal in value to God. God does not see men better than women or women better than men. But we do have different roles. We have different functions. And this is great. This is a good, beautiful thing. And just recognizing that and kind of like embracing that and being grateful for it too, I think. And we talked about this. And Melanie, if you guys listen, Melanie comes on a lot. And she and I talk about this a lot in our personal life when we're having conversations. Simple things of like when you're on your period, not being so like, oh, I'm on my period. But like, you know what? This is my fifth vital sign. Fifth or sixth vital sign. And this is great. If I don't get a period, that's actually a bad thing. The fact that I've got my period is a good thing. And you know, being so, things like that. Okay, I think those are all really the announcements. And I guess I'll get into it. But before, I want to talk a little bit about some of our sponsors. We have Culture of Life 1972. They have really cute jewelry and I'm not wearing my ring, but I'll be wearing my ring later on this week. You guys will see. They have cute jewelry, and 100% of their proceeds goes to pro-life causes. They have cute jewelry, cute clothes. Love them. Love them. Wonderful group. American Women Beauty. They have beautiful lipsticks and makeup and all these things. And the founder has been on the podcast. If you just search, those are the girls, American Women Beauty. We talk a little bit about that, why she started. Her story is fascinating. For Culture of Life, if you use the code Those Are the Girls 1972, you get 10% off. And if you use the code MAL, MAL15 for American Women Beauty, you get 15% off. And I also want to talk about Garnu. They have organic tampons, and it's a girls only club. They only use women to promote their brand. You don't have to worry about, some like Tampax, all of them getting men to promote their brand and blah, blah, blah. Don't have to worry about any of that stuff. Garnu, Macy, the founder of that, has been on the podcast as well. I don't remember the exact episode, but if you type in Those Are the Girls, Garnu, it will come up. And if you use the code OTHERGIRLS10, you can get 10% off your purchase with that. And it's organic. She talked about like why organic tampons are so much more important. So I only use organic pads. I only use organic now. Like I try to stay away from anything other than organic. After listening to that episode, you guys are, it's a really great episode. You should listen to it. So these are some of the sponsors that we have. And also too, another thing that the podcast does is we like to promote businesses that are run by Christian women that want to do positive things in our culture. We want to make sure we're putting our money where our mouth is. Once again, you cannot, obviously you can't get rid of everything all the time, or you just be living in the middle of nowhere with absolutely nothing. But where you can make the change. For tampons, simple, get subscription. You can do it. You're in the middle of an event in Oklahoma, and I'm just making a place. You're in the middle of an event in Oklahoma, and you need a tampon. You have to run to a store to get tampons because you don't have the subscription with you. Didn't know you're about to start your period. Okay, fine. But, you know, if you have a schedule and you know you're at home, it's so much easier to just go ahead. It's easier to go ahead and just make the transition to Garnu for that. Just an example. Okay, so, oh, we also try to only promote good quality. That's another thing too. A lot of times, some of these companies will slap on Christian and conservative and might not have the best quality. But if you're going through us, you can trust that we are doing our best to make sure it's only good quality. So just adding that. Okay, so those are all of our sponsors for this episode. And I'll have links and everything if you guys ever want to use something or want to look more into the brand. Okay, so this episode is really talking about female friendship and Galentine's Day and all of that jazz. So I want to talk about friendship first. I think friendship is so incredibly important, especially in a season where you might be struggling with singleness. Struggling with singleness is the only way to like really explain it. I think friendship is so important. So I have always been a social girl, obviously. Growing up, I always had friends, and I kind of want to say tons of friends. I don't know necessarily if it was like tons of friends as opposed to just like I was the girl who was friends with kind of everybody unless you didn't want to be my friend. And that's kind of how I see it today. Like, I'll be your friend unless you don't want to be my friend, or if I feel as if you don't want to be my friend. Like, I'm not going to force a friendship. When I was younger, I kind of tried to do that a couple times where there would be girls who I could tell weren't really my friends, but I really wanted them to be my friends. So I would try to like force things. But now at 28, I'm like, the moment I'm like, I can tell you don't really want to be my friend. Like, I'm not going to force it. And I think that comes with just age and maturity, realizing that not everybody is going to be your friend, and that's okay. So growing up, like I said, like I was friends with tons of people. And I did struggle a little bit with like the best friend. I think that's a problem with girls who are kind of like me, like extroverted. I've always been extroverted. I've actually kind of like reeled that in a little bit, I've noticed, as I've gotten older. I still love being around people, especially, and another thing that you realize when you get older is, you like being around people. And people give you energy. So, like, the difference between extroverts and introverts. Being around people gives you energy. I noticed for me, being around people gives me energy that, like, I genuinely enjoy. Like, I'm having fun with. Not just any people, I realized. Like, when I was younger, I think it kind of was just any people. But as I've gotten older and mature and, like, I have to balance my time a little bit better. Not every single person that I know in my life is someone who I'm having fun with and laughing and joking. So like sometimes leaving those conversations can kind of drain you, and you need to be aware of that. Anyway, so as an extrovert, I think that kind of, when you're friends with everybody, it is kind of hard to buckle down and figure out like who is your best friend. So kind of from, you know, middle school and elementary, I did struggle a little middle school, and kind of sort of high school. I kind of got my footing a little bit better in high school because my school that I grew up in was incredibly cliquey. I mean, it was, you stuck with your clique once you, High School Musical cliquey type. Well, before, you know, Troy and Gabriella shook it up. It was pretty cliquey. So I found my group, and honestly, I'm still friends with those people. Not only that, I'm still friends with a lot of those girls that I was in the group with, and I know that they have my back. Like, those are genuine friendships. Like, you know, some of them we might not talk every single day, but they're genuine friends of mine, and I very much appreciate them. So, and we weren't popular. That's another thing too. Like, I was never popular. I was quote unquote popular in the sense that everybody knew me. It also was a small school. It was a private Christian school. So it also wasn't like, you know, school, my friend graduated with her class. We went, it was like 6,000 people in one grade. We had 83. We had 83. So, but the school I went to before then, it was 16. So, like, everybody knew me, but this is how I always was spending in college. People would ask me. Everybody knew who I was. If you showed them a picture, they could say my name. They could say maybe one or two things I liked, but they couldn't really tell you who I was outside of, like, you know, I was president of a Christian club and blah, blah, blah. And they couldn't tell you stuff like that. And I wasn't invited to a lot of things outside of my friend group. And at the time in high school, you know, you're in high school and you're kind of like, man, like, I want to be more popular. I want to be a part of this group sometimes. Da, da, da. I think kind of my freshman and some of my sophomore year, I was kind of like that. But I don't know, by the time, I want to say my junior and senior year, I was kind of like, these are my friends. I love them. We have such a great time. And I think I got more of a perspective in, like, I don't know. I don't know if the people that I wasn't really friends with, those girls, I don't know if they're still friends. I really don't keep up with them. I have no interest in going to my high school reunion because everybody that I want to talk to is, I can just beep boop bop them. So I'm not really, I don't know. That's just me. But I know tons of people who want to go, who are going to go to there. It's more power to you. I just personally am just not, I don't know, I'm just not interested. Like I said, like, I can just beep boop bop people who I want to talk to. It's not like in the olden days, you know, where you might, like, my parents, like, their reunions are probably big and important because you can see people who you hadn't seen, but I'm friends with people I want to be friends with on Facebook. I can see them. We can have our own reunion. Like, it's not, you know, it's not the same. So I go throughout high school. When I get to college, friendship, that is kind of where friendship just is so different, but it's still, there's another season right after that. And then one more after that, but we'll talk about it. So college, I became friends with a group of girls right the first couple of weeks. And everyone in college tells you the first group of friends you're friends with are not your friends for life. And I was like, what are you? No, that's not true. Okay. Turns out I only really talked to two of those girls ever. Like, I think one or two out of that group, we might comment on each other's things. Maybe. Those other two girls I talk to semi-regularly, we do the happy birthdays, we kind of have catch-up conversations from the very first group of friends I had. And that's kind of it. Like, and making friends was kind of hard for me coming, and I think a lot of you can relate to this, growing up in a Christian school, being around Christian people all the time, and, like, Christians are not perfect. Christian school is not perfect. But I will say the people I hung out with, for example, we weren't drinking on the weekends. Like, that wasn't our thing. So going to college and meeting people who not only is that their thing, they've been doing that since, like, elementary school or even, you know, freshmen or not freshmen, sixth graders, they've been doing all high school, maybe even some in middle school. and, like, trying to navigate, where do you fit in? I mean, there were conversations that I had with some of these girls where I felt like, so young and dumb. We were all the same age. I was probably a little bit older than them because my birthday is in November. And they were just so much more, quote unquote, worldlier than me. I learned so much my freshman year from these girls. And then over the years, I made friends, lost friends, made friends, lost friends, made friends, lost friends. And now that I've graduated, I still talk to about two of those girls from the very first time. And then one of the guys from, oh, two of the guys, really, that I met later on throughout that time. And that has taught me, I'm not the person I was in 2013 when I went to college, as I am at 18 years old, as I am now at 28. Wow, it's been 10 years. Oh, my gosh. As I am now 28, I'm just not that same person. And with that changes the type of people I'm around and the type of people I choose to spend time with. So once you graduate college, you can either go into the workforce or go to grad school. When I went to my grad school, I went to a grad school program, and there I met, like, three people specifically who I'm still friends with, like the girl in the friend group. Like, we talk often-ish. When we do talk and is over the phone, it's never like, oh, hey, what's up, like, for 5 minutes. I mean, it's like 2-3 hours sometimes, you know. We just be talking and we're doing other stuff. Like, it's a real genuine friendship, and love these people, but it took me a minute to find them as well. How I solidified some friendships that year. I have to tell this story because I think it's so funny. So I was really having a hard time finding friends when I first got there. And like I said, I'm a social butterfly. Like, I love friends. I love being around people. I loved my apartment. I wanted to have people over. When I lived by myself and I, you know, solidified my friendships, I would have people over constantly. And I would make dinner for, I was in a friend group with a bunch of guys, and I would make dinner for us on Sunday night sometimes. And like everybody, some at first I was paying for everything. I was like, okay, this is expensive. But we're giving like $5. I'd make Brussels sprouts and chicken, and like we might watch a movie. We just do different things. It was just such a fun experience. Like, it was great. Anyway, but to get to that point, what I did was, so like I said, I struggled making friends, but my birthday is in November. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to invite everybody that I have met since I've been here. And I did. Every single person that I met since I've been here, I invited them to my birthday. And the ones that wanted to get to know me better, the ones that wanted to come, came. And to be honest, pretty much everybody that came to that party, I was still really good friends with for a long time. And like, that helped solidify some really good friendships that I have today. And one of the guys that came, he is a really good friend of mine. And we call each other cousin. Like, I think we're pretty decently close. And I actually met him like 2 days before that party with another one of my friends. And I was like, whatever, I'll just invite him too. And he said to this day, he just thinks that's like the craziest thing. Like, I didn't even know him, but I invited him to my birthday. And I was like, I was literally inviting everybody that I knew. Every single person I met, I invited. I said, come if you want, you don't have to. And the people that wanted to come came, and people who didn't want to didn't come. And it was such a fun time. So, you know, if you're struggling in grad school trying to do that, I suggest throwing a random birthday party and inviting everybody. Like, yeah, I want to say it was like maybe 10 people, maybe a little bit less. And it worked out. Like, that was such a fun birthday party. Like, I'm thinking about, I don't want to share everything that happened, but I'm thinking about, like, that was just so fun. We got to know each other a little bit better. Everybody played game. It was just, it was a fun night. And you know, I look back on that with like happiness and joy. So there's that season. Then the season after that, I moved back to, I moved back home because of the vid and everything. So I had friends that already lived here from growing up and like from other things, but it was so hard because here's the other thing. As you get older, you go into different seasons of life. You're in different seasons of life. So some of my friends, really outside of a group of friends that I'm gonna talk about later, everybody that I'm friends with is married. I have one friend who is engaged, but you know, we were just living two different lives when I first got here. And then eventually she met her now fiance, and that was, her life kind of revolved around that, which is fine. I think that's another thing I want to say for those of us who are single. And if you're listening, I think sometimes you can start to feel bad. And I'm not going to act like, oh no, I feel fine every time my friend picks her husband or her boyfriend over me. I'm not going to act like that, that I don't feel fine every time. But I think what I do is I try to remind myself, well, that's the reality. Like, this is her life partner. She should pick him before me. Like, that person is more important than I am. And that's the reality. And right now, like, I don't, you know, I don't have, my friends are the most important to me. So I don't have that person. So it kind of, sometimes it stings because I know that that person's not going to pick me over that person, but that's okay. Like, that's just, these are just phases and phases of life. And I think sometimes we have to recognize that that's okay. And that when it's your chance, you're probably going to do the exact same thing. I'm in a Facebook group with some girls who are single. And one of the girls was kind of explaining that she feels like really left out because her friend who's married, long story short, her friend was who's married kind of like, kind of pushed her to the side. She feels like, and will do stuff with some of the married friends more than she would do stuff with her single, with her, because she's single. She's the only single person in the group. And so much sympathy, because I get it. Like, and you know, if we have been having this podcast a year, maybe two, maybe 3 years ago, I might not have responded. I might not be responding the same way. I think it comes, like I said, it comes with like age. It comes with maturity. It comes with just realizing, where you are in life. But I tried to help her understand that, like, yeah, that's probably going to happen. She has more in common with her married friends than she does with you. It doesn't mean that that person doesn't love you. It doesn't mean that she doesn't care about you, but she just has more in common with her married friends than you. And that's okay. And especially when people have kids, like, I, and you know, in the group, people were saying, yeah, sometimes like you feel like you have to bend your will to them. And I'm like, especially my friends with kids, especially like, sometimes, yeah, it gets frustrating, but I'm way more flexible. When you have kids, you're not as flexible. I'm way more flexible. So, you know what? If she needs X, Y, and Z at this time, okay. That time works for me. You know, don't like drop everything for this one person, because that's also not healthy. But like, okay, she tells me this time. All right, let me see. All right, that fits into my schedule. We'll do it this time. And I think sometimes just recognizing that, and it's hard, but sometimes being okay with that just because you're in different seasons. So as I came back, it was very hard. It's very hard to make friends outside of college and grad school, stuff like that, because you're kind of like forced to make friends. In college, you're absolutely forced to make friends because you're around people. You have so much more free time. You're in walkable. You just go to this person's apartment, this person's dorm, this person's house. Easy peasy. Same with grad school. It was pretty easy. Like a lot of my really good friends that I met, we all lived in the same apartment complex. So it was very easy to just spend time together. There was a time during that season where I was living there where we would sometimes go to different people's houses for like dinner and like to play games. And it was just easier. You can't do that really when you are outside of that type of environment. So it does make it a lot harder, and you have to be a lot more intentional. And that has been something that I'm working on, is being intentional and truly letting my friends know that I care about their friendship. Even if I'm not present at all of these events that are taking place, I truly care about their friendship. Even if I don't, I'm terrible at texting. If you are my friend and you're listening to this, I apologize. If you have ever messaged me and we're acquaintances, I apologize. I am terrible at that. I don't know why. I used to not be, and then all of a sudden I was. I am working on that, though. I am. Getting back to people within a timely manner. So is really working on being intentional, because another aspect of friendship is no one's going to want to be your friend if you're not a good friend. So you could be struggling. You're wondering why you're struggling with your friendships, but you're not being a good friend to people. And that's something I'm always cognizant and try to work on. And as someone who, for example, I have this podcast, and there are times where I will, you know, not attend an event or something because I have a guest scheduled, or I'm late to something because I need to do something podcast related, or I can't do this because I'm speaking at this event, or, you know, so many things. And just letting your friends know that, like, hey, you value your friendship. This is also important too. I need to go ahead and do X, Y, and Z because this is also important. And realizing too, I think that for myself and many others, we're not necessarily in the space that we want to be in. So the way to get out, or way to get into the space that you want to be in, and the way to get out of situations you don't like, is to improve things and get better. And the only way to do that is to work hard and try to get different opportunities. So sometimes you have to prioritize that. I hope that made sense without like giving too much of my personal business. I hope that made sense what I just said. Let me use an analogy example. You know, right now, let's say you're working at Target, but your dream job is to own a pet cleaning service. Well, sometimes you might get an option to clean someone's pet that's at the same time as your group hang out to watch a movie. So which one do you pick? If you are trying to get to your goal, owning a pet cleaning service, you should probably pick the pet cleaning service and try to figure out how to do pet cleaning service, and then afterwards go and watch the movie or something like that. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, we have to also work toward our goals, and we can't let our friendships get in the way of that. And I don't mean that in like this, don't let your friendship get in the way of you getting it. I don't mean it like that. I just mean like, and once you own that pet cleaning service, get that under control, and then it's easier to manage some things. But while you're in a season where you're really not where you want to be, sometimes you have to make these sacrifices. But the thing is, you also have to let your friends know, maybe not necessarily those exact words, like, I'm working at Target and I absolutely hate it. I have to be this and that. So please excuse my absence. But just letting your friends know, hey, I'm choosing this because I really, this is kind of toward my goal. And it's up to your friend to like understand and recognize that. Like, if one of my friends told me that, I'd be very happy for them, and I would see how I could help. Maybe, like, I think that that is also the sign. If you want to have a good friend, you need to be a good friend. That is like the give and the take of the friendships. So my journey now with friends, I have a good group of friends that we're all in the same single season, and we're at different points of that single season. As you guys know, like I've said, like, I am personally fasting for 2023, dating, anything like that, but some of the girls are, you know, out dating, trying to meet people. So, you know, our things are a little different, our relationships are a little different, but we still are in the same season, and we still want what's best for each other. And I think that's also important to think about, like, your friends are people who you want what's best for. Switching gears a little bit, I just thought of this. I saw this TikTok, and I totally agree. And you guys let me know if you disagree. That'll be the question for the week. Let me explain the situation, then you tell me if you agree or disagree. The TikTok, she essentially said that, like, not all of your friendships are supposed to be deep. Some of your friendships are just people you go out with sometimes, people you are in book club with. And once you realize you have like one or two deep friendships, and once you like realize that, you let go of expectations of people. I saw that and I was like, I completely agree. I think sometimes we're expecting, I have friends like this who expect every single friend that they have to be really deep and to always tell them every single thing that's going on in their life, and like to be always super like, you're, you know, this person's sad, and they'll tell you, I'm sad because blah, 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 instead of, no, I'm just not feeling okay, and then moving forward. Or, you know what, this thing is going on in my life, and I'm sorry. I don't think that everybody deserves to know that, A. And B, like, if that's not what you want to do, I think that's okay. Some friendships are meant to be a little bit surface level, and I think that's okay too. But also, I will say that that is part of me being extroverted, I think, as well. Like, I'm friends with everybody until they don't want me to be their friend. I believe in unconditional friendship. Obviously, if someone, you know, murders my family, okay, I'm not going to be your friend. But like, we get into a fight, I don't end friendships over that. I honestly am trying to think of any friendship that like I ended. I can't really think of a particular friendship that I've ended. Maybe I have, and I just can't remember it. But like, friendships have ended because that person wanted it to end. Friendships have slowed down because of proximity, because neither one of us have the time to put in the effort. But to me, if I were to still talk to that person, I would still be that person's friend. Like, I wouldn't have anything against that person. And I truly wish all of them the best. So I think that's true. I think not all friendships are meant to be deep. You guys let me know what you think. That'll be the question on Spotify and on YouTube. And do you think all friendships are meant to be deep? And if they are meant to be deep, are all, like, do you not, like, how do you feel when someone isn't deep with you? Because I'm going to be honest, not all, tons of people, there are lots of people who I call friends and acquaintances, but not everybody knows me as deep as, like, my closest friends, my bestest friends. That's just not, I don't feel comfortable doing that with people. And I think that's okay. And I think that's also, too, when we put those expectations on people that they have to be deep, I think that's what hurts our feelings. I think that's what gets us, I think that's what hurts our feelings. Like, there's people who've had birthday parties where I thought, like, dang, I thought we were close in there. I'm not even invited to your birthday party. But then I'm like, no, we're not. We're surface level friends. And that's how I still like them. I have nothing against them. Perfect example. I talked about this before. I have maybe three friends that listen to my podcast in real life. And if I put more of the expectation that, like, they need to listen to this podcast to be my deep friend, then I think that, like, my feelings will be hurt more. I don't really have many friends in real life that, like, you know, support my jewelry or, like, actually listen to the podcast, order merch from the store, and that's okay. They're still my friends, but that doesn't change. And I know this is also controversial too. I said something like this once in like a group that like an entrepreneur group I'm in, and they all told me to cut people out like that. And I'm like, no, like, I don't think that's worth to cut someone out. It just shows, like, that's just not the level of friendship we have. So when XYZ happens, I'm not going to tell them because that's just not our friendship level. And I think that's okay. I'm sorry, I'm drinking for my Tiger Jar for weekly teacup smug. So that was just like a side note. I talked about my journey through friendship. I talked about this little side note that I wanted to discuss, I guess. And then I want to say, if you are a girl, you should definitely throw your friends a Galentine's Day party. I'm doing that for my friends. I'm so excited. I have all these cute things planned, and we're doing it's no boys allowed. I was going to do just singles, and then I was like, you know what? No, especially because y'all know I mainly have married friends anyway. And it came off bitter, I realized. Like, if I'm being honest with myself, it came off a little bitter. That's not what it's about. That's not what Galentine's is about. Galentine's is about being with your friends. It's about being girls and, like, looking cute and having fun and, like, understanding, like, your friendships are really important. Boys come and go. You might not marry that boy you're dating, but your friends, hopefully, are there forever. Even if you move out, like, that's another thing, too. Like, even moving shouldn't necessarily change it'll change like your friendship dynamic, especially if you live close to each other. Now you don't, but like if you're really deep friendship loving someone, you guys should be able to pick up right where you left off. And that's like how friendship is. Friendship is very different than boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife friendship relationship. And that's good. That's okay. Like the Bible talks about, you know, friendship, and we see examples of Jonathan and David, great friendship. We see examples of like friendship in Timothy, and there's just so many good positive things about being friends and like working really hard to have good female friends. That's something I did struggle with, is finding good female friends that I could. Not because I'm one of those girls that's still hard to be friends with type of girls, even though sometimes it does feel that way. And, you know, that's another conversation for another time. And it's not even like, oh yeah, I'm like friends with all these boys. I'm definitely not like that either, because all my friendships are completely platonic. But I did kind of feel like it was a little bit hard because of just the nature of friendship and femininity. And sometimes, you know, sometimes you and other women can kind of clash, or other women might not like you because of X, Y, and Z, or you might not like some other woman because of X, Y, and Z. So I prayed for good female friends, and I'm very grateful that I found some. And I pray that everybody listening, you guys get one or two that you can do stuff with, that you can hang out with. You don't have to have a big girl group. I've always wanted a big girl group, and I kind of sort of have one now. I'm saying kind of sort of. I've always wanted that, but you don't have to have that. And you know what? Like, if I were to move, I wouldn't have that anymore. It's different seasons for different things. So, you know, all that to say, invite all the girls, even if they're not in the same girl group, invite all your girly friends. You guys have a great time. There's so many examples on TikTok and Reels, and like mine is next week, next weekend after you see this. So like, you know, if you guys want to have it in March still, you can, I don't care. As long as you have one, I think if you have one, it'd be so fun. Tag us, tag those with the girls if you do. And I will definitely share the one that we're having the week after next. Well, one week from the day that this episode comes out. But yeah, you guys, like, just to wrap this all up in a nice, pretty feminine bow, friendship is so important. And I hope that hearing my story and like thinking about like where your friends are, like, where do you stand? Are you a good friend? Thinking about, like, you don't have to have super deep, deep conversations and super deep friendships with people for them to actually be your friend. I think thinking about those things and realizing that, hopefully that will make a difference. And I hope that gets you thinking about your friendships and how you can be a better friend to people, how you can accept friendship and all that. If you enjoyed this episode, please make sure you share with your friends. Rate, review, subscribe, all of that jazz, wherever you're listening to it. And thank you guys so much for listening. And I hope you have a great rest of your day. Happy Galentine's Day to all of my ladies out there who are listening, all of the gals, your gal pals. Have a great Galentine's Day. And see you next week. Bye.